Hello, Joey. What brings you out in the hills so late in the day?
I was at Frankie Watt's house. We had a 4-H meeting there.
You'd better ride on home before it gets dark. Old Clawfoot's around these parts again.
You mean that bear that was here last year?
That's right. He killed a foal of the Gordons and made off with a pig from the Bar 2 Ranch.
Say, I bet those were his tracks I saw on the other side of that hill. He sure must be big.
He is. The other side of the hill, you say, huh?
Uh-huh.
Well, we'll go on over there. And you set out for home right now, Joey. And tell Jim to put an extra watch in his stock tonight.
Yes, sir, I will. Come on, Fury, we better go home. Fury? What are you stopping for? What do you see, Fury? Why, it's only a baby lamb. Could be more than a couple of weeks old. Where'd you come from, little guy? Oh, it's shaking all over, Fury. Doesn't seem hurt, though. Just scared. Where's your mother, little fella? Guess old Clawfoot is back, all right. Fury, we gotta get him home before that old bear comes back again. I'm gonna do this. Good boy, Fury. Now wait till I get on. Got some appetite, Fury. Hi, Jim.
Hi, how's the patient?
Drank the whole bottle.
Well, he better learn to eat like a big boy from now on, because I ain't eating no more baby bottles.
It's a she, and I'm calling her Fuzzy.
I found out where she comes from. Belongs to Mr. Drayson over at the Bar X.
He wants her back?
Nope. He said you could have her.
Gee, that's swell. And listen, Jim, can I ask you something?
Oh, sure.
You know the 4-H club?
Yeah.
Well, everybody has an entry for the livestock show, except me. Could I enter Fuzzy? Please, could I, Jim?
You think she's championship material?
She'd win first prize. She's a beautiful lamb.
I understand that Frankie Watts has got a lamb that he's grooming for the show. It's supposed to be a pretty good one.
Fuzzy's a million times better. Please say yes, Jim.
I don't know, Joey. That's a big project. You'd have an awful lot to do between now and the show to get her in shape.
I can do it.
You'd have to feed her yourself and clean out her pen, comb her, groom her.
I'll do it, Jim.
Well, maybe fate saved Fuzzy from old Clawfoot just to get her that blue ribbon.
Then I can show her?
Sure.
Oh, boy. Thanks, Jim. She'll need another bottle at 4 o'clock, Pete.
Well, you fix it, son, because I ain't playing nursemaid to no lamb.
That's right, Pete. Joey, this is where you take over.
You bet. Thanks again, Jim.
Chow's ready, but where's Joey?
Oh, he'll be here. He went with Frankie over to the livestock pavilion to see about pens for the show.
You know, I never did see a kid say head up over anything. You'd think that blue ribbon was the most important thing in the world.
It is, to him.
And that lamb, like one of the family.
Well, grooming Fuzzy for the show is good experience for Joey.
You know, I don't know what that kid'd do if anything ever happened to that critter.
There she is. What'd I tell you?
Hey, Jim.
Yeah, it's a pretty nice animal.
Pretty nice? Look at that fleece. Ever see a tighter fleece than that?
Sure, on my lamb, Betsy. Better teeth, too.
What do you mean, better teeth? How can a lamb have better teeth?
I don't know, but mine does. And she's got better formation over the back, too.
You're gonna feel pretty sorry, Frankie, when the judge decides otherwise.
You haven't seen Betsy lately. Well, I gotta get home and help Dad with the chores. Ride over tomorrow and see what a prize-winning lamb looks like.
All right, I will. Betsy.
Oh, hi, Joey. What did Frankie think about your lamb?
He thinks whatever he's got is better than anybody else's. Always bragging.